Yo, what is going on, guys? It is the Ultimate Frozen Fan back here for a quick little unboxing slash review slash show off video. This is the Sonic the Hedgehog 25th anniversary art book from Cook and Becker. Apparently they make a lot of art books for like video games and stuff, and this was released to commemorate the 25th anniversary of Sonic. Apparently they released one like this before, but this is an updated version that has all the way from the original Sonic the Hedgehog to the newest game Team Sonic Racing, so they added a few more things. I think the old one only came up to like Sonic Boom or something like that, so this has added like Sonic Forces, Sonic Mania, Team Sonic Racing. So it is huge. It is a lot bigger than I had expected, but that's okay. This thing is awesome. So you look at the front, on the side it's a Sonic the Hedgehog. I don't see the Cook and Becker logo anywhere, but trust me, that's who published it and that's where it's from. So it comes in this nice protective plastic, so let's get this off and open up the book. So yeah, this has all kinds of like concept art for characters, game covers, and probably like game characters, and probably even like maybe a little bit of backstory of Sonic, stuff like that. So they have two versions of this. They have a collector's edition for $100, or they have the standard edition for $40. So money was kind of tight at the time, so I just got the standard edition, but I'm okay with that. So looking at the front, we got a nice sketch of Sonic. You open it up, and there's the ring. That. Sonic the Hedgehog. Index. Number 5 is about this book. Part 1 is the classic Sonic years. Part 2 is shifting gears. Part 3 is modern Sonic. And part 4 is full circle. This book. Here we have the three Sonics. We have classic Sonic, modern Sonic, and Sonic Boom Sonic, who actually is from another universe, so remember that. That's why the characters are all redesigned. Sonic Boom takes place in an alternate Sonic universe. A history of the design of Sonic the Hedgehog. Look at that. Whole thing of like Sonic running up the loop to Green Hill. That's awesome. Yeah, I think some of these pages fold out to like extend and whatnot. So, classic Sonic. A Sega comic, it looks like. The Sega Genesis. Oh, yeah, so. Look at this, the early concept. This was the original Sonic. Sonic was originally going to be a bunny, like that, and some other designs of what the heck Sonic could be before they settled on a hedgehog. So yeah, so this has, like, all into the history of Sonic and even Sega's consoles, so this is amazing. A lot more concept art of classic Sonic, 8-bit versions of how he runs, and spin dashes. Ooh, that's cool, some tracing paper. Version of Sonic running up. I mean, I guess that's. I don't think that's Green Hill Zone. That's gotta be something else. But, anyways. So. Some more sketches of probably level design. That looks like Vector the Crocodile right there. I don't know who these guys are. Maybe they're the members of Sonic's band from like Sonic Underground or something, because he's a singer. I don't know. Genesis does what Nintendo don't, so then we've probably got some insight about the Genesis, and there's Free Sonic Comic, Sonic the Hedgehog game across all regions. That's what it looked like in Japan, I believe, and this is the American version we got. This one, I'm not quite sure what region that one is, but yeah, the main starting screen. Ding 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 ding. Sonic wagging his finger, so awesome. Some of Sonic's death animations. Nice. The concepts of the Badniks. Crab meat. That spike ball. I don't know a lot of the names of a lot of these guys because I didn't play the classic Sonic games as much as the modern Sonic games. Because I was born in 1994, so when they were coming out, I was just a baby. Introducing Dr. Ivo Eggman Robotnik. So now some designs of Eggman through the years. Funny story, he was always called Eggman in Japan. That was supposed to be his original name. But when they brought him to the States, his name was changed to Dr. Ivo Robotnik without permission of Sega. So what they did was they made Eggman a nickname given to him by Sonic, and his official name be Ivo Robotnik. So, but some people still call him Dr. Robotnik. It's to each his own. So yeah, so here's some designs for, more designs for Eggman. So, this is the Sonic Boom Eggman, of course. Eggman from 2013. That's Eggman from Sonic 06. Awesome game. And that's probably the Eggman from, like, the Adventure days, I would say, maybe. So, some more classic Sonic. Like, how high he is and, like, his color palettes that he's made up of. Nice. There's one of the bonus levels where you have to get the Chaos Emerald. Go after the rings. Sonic 2. With introducing Tails. That was the first game to introduce Tails. Some more level designs. Introducing Miles Tails Prower. His real name is Miles Prower, which is a play on miles per hour, but everyone calls him Tails because he has two tails that allow him to helicopter. More tracing paper images. So cool. It's Tails through the years. Sonic Boom Tails, of course. Sonic Heroes Tails. 2011, that was probably either Sonic Colors or Sonic Unleashed Tails. Maybe even Generations, I don't know. More animations of Tails. Oh, look at this. We can open this thing all the way up. Oh, well, not all the way up. I thought that this one opened up too, but anyway, so there they are going through Chemical Plant Zone. Everyone's favorite level. I'm being sarcastic. Everybody hates Chemical Plant Zone. The bonus levels running through a tube, which were brought back for Sonic Heroes, which I did not like. Super Sonic, yeah! Some of Eggman's mechs that he can go into. Metal Sonic from Sonic CD. Introducing Metal Sonic. Some more concept art and sketches of Metal Sonic. Metal Sonic through the years. So, here he is in the classic Sonic CD, I guess. There he is from Sonic Rivals 2, I recognize that pose. And this one, 2015, that one might be Sonic Generations, probably? I don't know, or Sonic... No, I don't think he was in Sonic Forces. More Badnik designs. Amy Rose, Sonic's love interest. She looked a lot more like Sonic back in the old days, and she had a very different outfit. As you can see, she had the same quills as Sonic. And she wore a green top with the orange skirt and pink shoes. And she's in love with Sonic. I don't know if Sonic returns the favor or not. I don't think so. He's always trying to get away from Amy. Amy through the years. So see how much she's changed. Sonic Boom Amy, of course. So, this is the Adventure Amy. Heroes Amy. God, what came out in 2015? Probably Forces, I want to say. Yeah, probably Forces. Look at that 8-bit Amy that we all know and love, not the classic Amy, with all kinds of animations of her hammer. I didn't know they made an 8-bit Amy of the one that we have today. More Robotnik machines, Sonic being chased by Robotnik, Amy being captured by Metal Sonic. Where's Sonic? Sonic, where are you? Oh, there he is, he's like looking up. Oh, he's right there. He's still looking up. Okay. So, yeah. More sketches and whatnot. Nice, nice. Sonic 3 and Knuckles. These were two separate games for the Mega Drive that could be connected to each other and, like, extend the game. So if you had both of them, you can unlock the full game. Like, one just sat on top of the other. It had, like, a connector on top. Pretty cool. And there's my boy Knuckles. Love Knuckles, he's my favorite. So some concept art design for it. Knuckles. Knuckles through the years. Adventure, Sonic Adventure 2, I believe. Sonic Heroes. Boom or Forces. No, not Boom. Forces or Racing. Sonic Boom, of course. Nice, nice. Concept of 8-bit Knuckles, Sonic Spinball, Dr. Robotnik's Mean Bean Machine, I believe. Part 2, Sonic 3D. So then they did Sonic 3D. Sonic R starts kind of getting into 3D, but nowhere near to the point of this beauty right here, Sonic Adventure on the Dreamcast. So, yeah. Some of the characters from there that you can play as. All cool, they have 3D versions of them as well as 2D versions. Nice. Oh, there's City Escape from Sonic Adventure 2. Here's a bunch more Sonics through the years. Sonic and Shadow, nice. And some screenshots from all the levels in Sonic Adventure 2, my favorite Sonic game. Concept art. The Chao, they're absolutely adorable. My sister and I logged so much time taking care of these things. We loved it. I always wanted to make one look like Knuckles, but you can only do that with the action replay. She managed to get one to look like Shadow, though. Speaking of Shadow, there's Shadow right there. Looks like some concept designs of what he could be. At one point, he looked just like Sonic, but with longer quills. But I'm like, no, we need something different than Sonic. Nice. Nice. Big the Cat! Everyone's favorite character, because they love his gameplay in Sonic Adventure. Fishing! Everybody loves to fish. E-102, Chaos, Rouge the Bat, Tikal, Cream the Rabbit. I think these are the Sonic Advance games in Japanese. Pretty sure. Sonic Heroes, E-123, Team Chaotix. That might be Sonic Battle for the Game Boy Advance. I think that's what it was called. Blaze the Cat. These are the guys from Sonic Riders who I don't know their names. Alright, Silver the Hedgehog and the Sonic 06 cover. Go Sonic 06. Sonic Unleashed, Sonic the Werehog. Sonic and the Black Knight. Sonic 4. Sonic Colors. More Sonic Colors. Sonic Generations. Nice. Green Hill in 3D in Sonic Generations. Sonic Lost World. Versus the Fiendish Five or whatever they were called. Sonic Boom. I admit I have not played both of these ones because they were both for the Wii U, which I don't have, but I really want to play those ones. Hoping I am able to someday. There's Sticks the Badger. More Sonic Boom. The reason I know her name is because I watched the Sonic Boom TV series. Loved it. Sonic Mania. Haven't completed it yet. I'm stuck on the stupid Titanic Monarch Zone with the stupid plasma sphere thing that Sonic rolls around and has to jump up to. You know those things where like there's electricity inside and you put your finger on it and it follows your finger and whatnot? Well, that's basically what there is in Titanic Monarch Zone. More Sonic Mania. More Sonic Mania. Do not know who these guys are. Know their names. Once again, didn't really play the classic Sonic as much. I think that's still... This is all Sonic Mania. Nice, nice. Cute. Okay, some of the robots. Still more Sonic Mania. Sonic Forces. This game I loved. Still waiting for a proper sequel to that, the next 3D platforming Sonic game. Not like a racing game with Sonic in the car, that's more like a spin-off. So, Sonic Forces, characters that you can make, Infinite, kind of reminds me of Mephiles the Dark from Sonic 06, some more levels. There's Team Sonic Racing, which I haven't picked up, and I don't know if I will, because, one, I really suck at driving games. I don't do good driving, like steering and everything. And two, I've never really been a fan of the Sonic driving games. So, and then I guess this shows the complete timeline of, like, every Sonic game and what year it released. Pretty cool. So, yeah, and there we go. There you have it. That's the end. So, very, very awesome in-depth book. Love it. I am happy to have it. If you want to pick this thing up for yourself, head on over to Cook and Becker. I will provide the link to this in the description below. And if you enjoyed this video, be sure to drop a like. Let me know in the comments what you think of this book and if you're going to be picking it up for yourself. And share this video with your friends. Ultimate Frozen Fan, signing off. Peace.